Good morning, everyone. Happy Sunday. We're going to get ready to worship God through music in just a few moments. But first, I have a question for you. We talked about it last week if you were watching. Do you remember why we should obey God? Ready? You remember? We should obey God because He made us, He loves us, and His plans are good. Today's story is going to show us that God loves people who do not even love Him. I can't wait for you to hear it. But first, get on up off your couch or chair and get ready to worship God.
Raindrops rolling off my brim, street lights got the pavement glistening. Touchdown, I fall into your arms, right where I belong, your everlasting arms. And where would I be without you? I'd be packing my bag when I need to stay. I'd be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'd be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you.
Conquerors through Him who loved us, through Him who loved us. What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? Nothing, nothing. From the love of God that is in Christ Jesus. What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? Nothing. From the love of God that is in Christ Jesus. What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? Nothing, nothing.
Stop it. Quit. I hear you laughing. I hear you are laughing at me because I think you think something's different about me. Is there something in my teeth? No, there's nothing. I can't see anything in my teeth. Is there glitter on my face? No. But seriously, you need to stop it because Miss Kara is going to tell you an amazing story about how God might just punish people, kind of like your parents punish you when you don't listen. But first, let's remember our memory verse. Ready? It is 2 Peter 3:9. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some understand delay, but is patient with you, not wanting any of you to perish, but for you to come to repentance. Now, remember that Bible verse, because it's kind of important to this story that Miss Kara is going to learn, because, or she's going to teach you, and you're going to learn. That's how it's supposed to go. Anyway, have a great day, and we will see you next week.
Hello, Church at Nolensville Kids. It's me, Miss Kara, and I'm here to bring you your Bible story for this week. We are in 2 Kings again, so we have been in the book of Jonah, we have been in the book of Hosea, and now we are back to 2 Kings today. So go look in your Bible for this story after we're finished. It's in 2 Kings 17 in the Old Testament of your Bible. Miss Kara, it tells you these stories, but I always want you to know that the full story is in God's Word, is in the Bible. So always go back, and you could even check to see if Miss Kara got a few things wrong. So you always go and read this story for your own self, okay? And if you can't read, then ask your mom and dad to read. I'm sure that they would be so happy to read it for you. I'm happy to be here with you today. Our story today is about, it's a little bit of a sad story, but I promise it has a, we will have a happy turn at the end. So this today is when the nation of Israel gets captured by some enemies. Bum, bum, bum. So our last week we learned about Hosea, which was a prophet that God had sent to try to beg Israel through Hosea's life to say, turn from your sin. And Hosea, remember, he went after Gomer and went after Gomer and had to even pay money to buy her back at one point. And God loves us even more than Hosea loved Gomer. And he used Hosea's, and he used Hosea's life and used Hosea's obedience to tell us about how much God loves us and how much he wants to be with his people. So even though God loves us and he wants to be with us, does that mean that people can keep sinning against God with no consequences? No. Sin always has consequences. Every decision in life has consequences. Obedience has consequences, usually good consequences. Things typically go well with you when you are living in obedience to God. That doesn't mean that life will be all rosy and without thunderstorms, but it means typically things will go well with you if you are in obedience to God. Things will typically not go well with you or if you are living in a disobedience from God. So we're going to hear today about how even though God loves his people, he wants to be with his people, he cannot allow them to keep sinning. He loves them too much. It would be like this. It would be like if your dad, if you went to your neighbor's house and you took one of your neighbor's toys and you pretended that it was your own and you took it without telling your neighbor, and your dad found out about it. And instead of your dad finding out about it, I know if I thought my dad was finding out about it, I would be shaking in my boots because I knew that I would be in big trouble. But it would be like if instead of getting in big, huge trouble, your dad said, okay, that's fine. Yeah, you can keep that toy. That would be terrible for the child, because what would the child do the next time he saw a toy maybe that was his neighbor's that he really liked? He might think, oh, I'm going to get that other toy. And he would start to have a pattern of stealing and taking things that were not his. It is good for us when we do things that are not in accordance to how God made us to be, that are not in the way that God wants us to walk. If we didn't have consequences that kept us on the path of obedience, we would make terrible decisions. And so like a good father, like our good earthly father, some of us are lucky to have good earthly fathers who give us consequences when we make sinful choices. God is an even greater father, and there are consequences to our sin. And so then when the nation of Israel was divided, so let's go back a little bit. Who remembers King Solomon? King Solomon was King David's son. King Solomon had a son called Rehoboam, and Rehoboam was not a good king like his dad and grandfather. And so God took some of the tribes of Israel away from Rehoboam, and he put them in the northern kingdom. And remember, the kingdom split into two. There was the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom. And so now the northern kingdom, we're going to talk about the northern kingdom today. And all this time, Israel has ignored the prophets. They have ignored Elijah. They have ignored Elijah. They have ignored Jonah, although the people of Nineveh did turn back to God. There was Amos and there was Hosea. So this was about 200 years. Sometimes the Israelites would follow, but most of the time they were in disobedience against God. And there are consequences to their sin and to their idolatry of false pretend gods. And so God had been very, very patient with the Israelites. He had been slow to anger. But God is holy. He cannot be in the place of sin. And he wants to be with his people. So if he wants to be with his people, but his people are sinful, something has to happen. And so that's what today's story is about. God had done so many things for the Israelites. He had been a good father. But finally, he had had enough. God had made the people of Israel. He had saved them from the Egyptians way, way back in the Old Testament. He had defeated all those armies and had made the promised land for Israel. And he had told them, listen, your hearts were made to worship me. Your hearts are made to love me. But the people did not worship God. They did not love God. And what has Miss Kara told you? If your heart is not loving and worshiping God, it is loving and worshiping something else. And that's exactly, the Israelites are exactly like us. And by this time, God had said, enough is enough. And so he allows some pretty scary things to happen. The people of Assyria and the people of Israel, so there was some enemies, their names were the people of Assyria, and then here is Israel, and they did not get along. And so, and Assyria's army was very strong and mighty. They were much mightier than the Israel's army. And so there was a king of the time of Israel. His name was Hoshea. And and I hope I'm saying his name right, Hoshea, I forgot the don't forget the Hoshea. And King Hoshea did evil things. Remember our evil eyebrows with our evil kings a few weeks ago? Get out your evil eyebrows. We're having some evil kings again today. And King Hoshea gives money to the king of Assyria. Now there's a problem with this. Because they're beholden to, because they've paid money for the people of Assyria not to fight them, they kind of have to do what Assyria says. And the people of Assyria are not God's people. They do not do things the way that God says. So now Hoshea has to do what the Assyrians say, and he's not liking it. So what he does is, instead of asking, he's kind of in a bind here. He has a problem that he needs to fix. Now, what he should have done is he should have cried out to God for help. He should have cried out to Yahweh. Did he do that? No, he didn't. He did not. So he goes to the king of Israel. He goes to the king of Egypt, and he makes a deal with Egypt. And so he stops giving money to the Assyrians. Now, here's another problem. He had a problem with Syria, and now he's made a deal with Egypt, and he's going to not give him money anymore. So there's another problem. So what's going to happen? The people of Assyria are going to attack the city. And this is the city of Samaria. And so the city of Samaria has this big, huge, strong wall, like a really strong and mighty wall. And for 3 years, the Assyrians attack the city. And they would let no one bring them supplies. And finally, the king of Assyria captures Samaria, and he forces the people to leave their home, and he binds them with ropes and hooks, and he made them walk for hundreds of miles to Assyria, and the northern kingdom of Israel was destroyed. Now, that is a little bit of a wah-wah ending, because now this northern kingdom is no more. It has been destroyed. The people are captured. But remember, when we read these Bible stories are many stories that make up the full story of Scripture. So yes, sin has consequences, but God made a way from the very beginning for his people to be with him. God made a way from the very beginning, and his plan from the very beginning was Jesus. So we know in several hundred years that Jesus is coming. He is the promised one, and he will make all things new. So even though the story ends on a bump, there's also good news coming ahead. And that is why we read the whole of Scripture, is because we get to see the beauty and the majesty of all of God's word. So that is the end of our story today. It was how the northern kingdom of Israel was destroyed. And I hope you enjoyed today's story. Go read it, 2 Kings 17. And I will see you next week. Goodbye.